Enable the Skinify Rig add-on in Preferences. And enable the Rigify add-on as well. Press Shift-A and add an armature of choice. In Pose mode, select the bones that you want to create the geometry from. Open the Create tab in the Option panel, and in the Skinify Rig options, click Add Shape. Hide or delete the armature. With the geometry selected, press Ctrl-A and choose Visual Geometry to Mesh. This applies the skin and subdivision modifiers that were added automatically. Now you can use the Inflate brush in Sculpt mode to inflate the geometry. From here, you can separate all by loose parts in Edit mode, and then join the parts together that you want to remesh. In Object mode, press Shift-A and select Meta Ball Ball. Press Shift-D to duplicate it, then move it to where you want to add it to the overall volume. There are also a few other Meta Ball primitives to choose from. You can press S to change their size, R to rotate, and of course G to move. When you're happy with the block out, click on the main shape instead of the individual circles. Right-click and choose Convert to Mesh. In Edit mode, select all and go to Mesh Symmetrize. You may have to switch the symmetrize direction. Then press M and choose By Distance so you can clean up overlapping vertices by reducing the merge distance. Now you have a symmetrical base mesh that you can sculpt on. Let's look at going from a thumbnail sketch to a sculpted 3D mesh. First, we need a base mesh. Drag and drop your thumbnail sketch into the front viewport. Press Alt-G to make sure its location is reset to the world origin. Convert it to grease pencil using the Trace Image to Grease Pencil option. Then convert that to a path. And finally, convert the path to a mesh. Hide or delete the original thumbnail empty and the grease pencil object. Select all the vertices in Edit mode and press M, choose By Distance. This way you can reduce the amount of vertices. Then select all in Edit mode and press F to fill the shape. Using Circle Select, select and dissolve or delete any vertices that aren't part of the outline. Add a mirror modifier set to bisect so the model is symmetrical. Then add a solidify modifier and a remesh modifier. And set the remesh modifier to voxel. Adjust the voxel size, but be careful. Too small can cause Blender to freeze. Now you can add primitive meshes to the shape in Edit mode. These will be merged automatically with the rest of the model by the voxel modifier. Don't worry about achieving perfection at this point. This is just a base mesh for the next sculpting stage. If you found this topic interesting and would like to know more, don't forget that you can find it in my Blender Secrets ebook, along with almost 2000 pages of other tips. To get an idea of what the ebook is like, you can download the free sample from my website.